I bought a new gaming mouse again. Months ago, I bought one of these. So Zelotes Optical, or I can't even pronounce it, Zelotes Optical Mouse. It's this thing. It's a nice looking, pull back, nice looking, this is a new one right out of the box. I bought one 16 months ago, and I bought another one right now, because the other one is starting to break. How do I know that? Well, I'm getting the USB disconnect sound when I move the mouse and things like that. So why would I buy the exact same mouse again when the first one broke? Because they're cheap. I paid $14 for this thing. $14 for a gaming mouse. And I like it. I like the mouse. I'm used to its feel. And it's okay, so it's not 100% reliable. But the last time I paid $15 for it, the price has dropped a dollar since last time I bought it. And it's a nice gaming mouse, at least to me, it seems to do everything that I want to do. It's got the buttons I want. It's got the functionality I want. It's got the nice look and feel that I have. It's interesting that it's color. So I'm going to pull this one out and replace it. And with the new one that I just got out of the box, and I'm going to take the one that's sort of broken or breaking and put it over on my laptop for work. But my laptop for work doesn't need a good gaming mouse, but I miss the buttons on the side, the thumb buttons. I just have a normal old little mouse on that thing. And once you get used to having the thumb buttons for like back and forward, you really want them on a mouse. And I don't do that much mouse commands for work. I've learned all the keyboard shortcuts, which is for doing most of my things. I don't go through menus, I go keyboard shortcuts. So, and I actually get irritated when I have to use the mouse to go and do things, because you're not as fast. You have to take your hands off the keyboard, go grab the mouse and do things. Side note, people to test applications. This is something that I learned for working for a company that really knew how to, we built applications for data entry, and you did not want somebody to be able to have to touch the mouse. And we had people who, there was one woman who typed 130 words a minute. She was extremely fast. You want to build an application that is very, very fast. And I see people who, it just takes forever. Like, for example, when I go to the chemo center, for them to check me in, it's just click, type, click, 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 type. It really is inefficient. And if you're going to build an application that you don't need a mouse. In fact, that was one of our tests. We would you start up the application, then we would remove the mouse from the machine. And a person had to be able to do all the data entry without the mouse. It's an interesting usability test to see if you can do that. And they could do that. There are other things with barcodes you can do, which really get you going fast. But I don't use a mouse that much at work. I use it much more for home and gaming a little bit. I'm more of a controller type person when I game, but I do use a mouse a bit, and I like the gaming style mice that are there. And this one is cheap. And you go, oh, but it broke. Well, yes, I could spend $75 to $100. I have bought expensive mice in the past. I bought some Logitech, the G6 or 7 mouse that they had for a long time. I love that mouse too, but that one finally died. And then I had other Logitech mice, and then I was looking for a new Logitech mice, and I was going $80 or $90. And I go, okay, I can do that. And then I see this thing. It's a $15 mouse, $14 now. And I go, well, okay. I spend about that much when I go out to lunch, have a nice lunch. And I go, okay, I'll drop that and see what I get. And I got it, and it lasted 16 months. looked at the calendar and I see, yeah, what day it is and when I bought it. That's the nice thing about going on Amazon. You can go back and see when you ordered it, know exactly when you ordered it, when it arrived, and you can then figure out how long it lasted. And you go, 16 months. Okay, it's less than $1 a month. But it's not the greatest. It doesn't last. And it's probably the cord up in there. And you could probably take it apart and fix it, but I'm not going to do that. I just replace it. So that's my thought. I like the mouse, and you might get some cheap. I'd like to hear what people think about cheap mice, particularly cheap gaming mice. I mean, this one's got, it's your standard buttons. You can see up here. It's got these are the buttons on the side that I really like. It lights up, changes color. It didn't like the, yeah, you don't want to plug it into a USB 3.0 hub, which I tried. That it didn't like, and I think that's probably the hub's fault, but I'm not sure. But I plugged in the motherboard, and you've got all these nice buttons on this thing, and it works, and it's comfortable. It looks funny until you get used to it. And but it fits well on my hand. It's the right size for my hand. It works well. It's right-handed. I don't think they have a left-handed model, but it's because it sits there right with your thumbs, and you got all the buttons you need, at least that I need. But it's cheap. And okay, it doesn't last, but that's okay. I have no problem with things that wear out. Quote, planned obsolescence, because I replace them every, if you have to replace it every 12 to 14 months, 12 to 16 months, okay, I'm okay with that. It would be nice if they lasted longer, but for that price, I mean, most of my mice haven't lasted 5 years. Maybe they have. Maybe I've had some mice that have lasted 5 years, but that's what you're talking about in price difference. Buying a $60 mouse that lasts for 5 years, or a $14 mouse that lasts for a year and 4 months, which would you do? I think I'd do the year and 4 months, because it's like, it's the same challenge. I go to the grocery store. Do I buy a half gallon of milk, or do I buy a gallon of milk? And for me, it depends upon how much. Because gallon of milk will get closer to the expiration date, and I am very sensitive about that right now because I have a compromised immune system because I'm going through chemo. So I would prefer to, I actually gauge about how much milk I'm going to be drinking, because that cold milk I can't drink when I'm right over chemo. But it's interesting to, so you the same thing is. What's the expiration date? Because if it's cheap and you need to know you're going to replace it, maybe there's another model that comes out and it gives you an opportunity to try some new things. So I recommend taking a look at this. I'll put a link down below of where it's at, and you tell me what you think. Do you like mice that last for a long time, or are you willing, that cost a bit more, or are you willing to try a mouse that only lasts for a little over a year? I look forward to hearing what you think about this video. Let me know in the comments below. Do you want to buy a good mouse that lasts for a long time, or are you willing to try a good mouse that doesn't last for a long time, but it's a lot cheaper? If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you want to subscribe, there's a button down below. And if you're interested, there's some more content to the right. Thank you.